Israel wins Eurovision, Netta Barzilai claims crown, as UK SuRie finishes 24th after she was stopped mid-song by protester who grabbed her microphone before being dragged off stage. Israel pipped bookies favourite Cyprus to take this year's Eurovision crown after a protester grabbed the microphone of the UK SuRie mid-performance during an action-packed night in Lisbon. Netta Barzilai, singing the popular song Toy which has already racked up more than 25 million views on YouTube, was second favourite prior to this evening's show, but beat Cyprus Eleni Ferreira in a closely fought contest. The song, which the artist said was about women's empowerment and represented the hashtag MeToo movement, proved a hit with both the public and jury and saw her narrowly secure victory over Eleni Ferreira's performance of Fuego. She managed to secure the win with 529 points, compared to runner-up Cyprus on 436 points. Austria's Caesar Sampson, who was winning the jury vote, finished third with 342 points for his performance of Nobody But You. Speaking after her win, Barzilai said, "I am so happy. Thank you so much. Thank you for supporting diversity." The next Eurovision is expected to be held in Israel following the country's fourth win in the competition's 63-year history. Barzilai's win was just one of a number of dramatic moments during the course of the evening. Earlier, the UK SuRie was dramatically interrupted in the middle of her performance of Storm when a stage invader snatched her microphone, to the disbelief of BBC One commentator Graham Norton. Britain came 24th out of 26 nations, with a total score of just 48, much lower than the 111 points Lucy Jones won last year. BBC One commentator Graham Norton, who appeared stunned after the stage invasion, said, "That is a terrific result for Israel. I'm afraid SuRie, for all her braveness and professionalism, came 24th. She really is a national heroine. After tonight, it was extraordinary. I don't know how she coped in those horrible circumstances. A lot of people will be watching her performance and cheering her on because she did a terrific job for the UK, and it's a shame that wasn't reflected." The stage invader is believed to be rapper and activist Dr. A.C., who shouted down the microphone, "For the Nazis of the UK media, we demand freedom." SuRie was left clapping along for around 20 seconds before she was given another microphone and courageously carried on with her performance. Despite being given the chance to perform again, SuRie turned it down, saying she had no reason to take to the stage again. BBC Eurovision tweeted, "Folks, this is the latest on the SuRie situation." SuRie was offered the option to perform again by the EBU. SuRie and her team are extremely proud of her performance and have together decided that there is absolutely no reason to perform the song again. The Eurovision Song Contest tweeted that the stage invader who stole SuRie's microphone was in police custody, adding that the EBU network regrets the incident. In a statement, they said, "The EBU regrets a stage invasion took place during the United Kingdom's performance at the Eurovision Song Contest Grand Final in Lisbon this evening. The person responsible is currently in police custody." The UK singer SuRie and her team were offered the option to sing again but decided not to because they were extremely proud of her performance and have decided that there is absolutely no reason to perform the song again. The invader was advertising his book The Workings of the UK State Mafia, UK Media on his t-shirt. Under the title, he had a message reading, "Order this now on Amazon." The stage invader is thought to have previous history with similar stunts after he interrupted the National Television Awards in January as Dermot O'Leary was on stage. He also stormed the Voice Live final last year as Emma Willis prepared to announce the results. Northern Irish talk show host Stephen Nolan also claimed the same stage invader crashed his program last year. The UK arm of Eurovision wrote on their official Twitter account, "Just to confirm SuRie is okay. More news when we get it. Hashtag Eurovision. Sick." Graham Norton said after she was interrupted, "We are not sure what's going to happen and if we'll get the opportunity to perform again." He added, "She coped so well, I'm in awe of her. Really, really terrific job from SuRie." The odds of the UK winning the competition plummeted after the incident. Ahead of the competition, SuRie was given odds of 401 to win, although that was slashed to 51. Oddsecker spokesperson George Ellick said, "Bookies have been forced to take action on a controversial moment during SuRie's performance. Due to the highlighted attention on SuRie's song, punters are piling in on the UK to scoop the competition, something that was unthinkable just earlier on today. Fans have taken to Twitter to hail Harlow-born singer's courage for carrying on her performance despite the invasion." J.K. Rowling added in her own post, "That was everyone who's ever been on stage's worst nightmare and it must have been scary, but what a pro, what a recovery at SuRie official hashtag Eurovision, sick." Another fan wrote, "The way SuRie handled that will go down in the history books for one of the most iconic moments at Eurovision. Very few people could do what she did after that. I would be afraid for my life after that, sick." Whilst another shared, Someone tried to wrestle SuRie's mic whilst she was performing her own song. She then carried on. What a hero. Hashtag Eurovision. Sick. SuRie had worked with Belgian contestants as a backing singer at Eurovision 2015 and as a music director last year. She was one of 26 contestants representing their country at the 63rd edition of the competition. This year's competition is being held in Lisbon, Portugal, where Cyprus and Israel were among the pre-performance favorites to win. Cyprus' Eleni Ferreira, who is a huge star in Greece, was tipped by bookmakers as the favorite to win with her fiery ballad Fuego, which features a heavily choreographed routine reminiscent of Britney Spears or Beyoncé. Israel's Netta Barzilai's Toy, whose lyrics "I am not your toy" sum up the concerns of many women who have adopted the hashtag MeToo movement against sexual harassment. The 25-year-old accompanies the up-tempo song with drills, clucking sounds and chicken-like dance moves. Speaking before the contest, she said, "The song has an important message, the awakening of female power and social justice, wrapped in a colorful, happy vibe. I think the song is hashtag me too, but it's an empowerment song for everybody, and everybody can find themselves in it." Britain's long way to win the competition is expected to continue tonight as SuRie is tipped to finish dead last with her rendition of Storm. The UK has not won Eurovision since 1997, and were given odds of just 2-1 to finish in last position tonight. Ireland's Ryan O'Shaughnessy performed third from last, and a victory tonight could see the Emerald Isle extend its record for the most Eurovision wins, currently at 7. Voting began after the final contestant had performed. In each participating country, a jury and viewers award between 1 and a maximum 12 points to their favorite songs. Those votes are combined to give each country a single score. No country can vote for its own act, and by tradition, each announcement is made in English or French. Ukraine kicked off this evening's competition with Melovin emerging from what appeared to be a coffin which doubled up as a piano, shortly followed by Spain's entry singing Tu Canción, which roughly translates as Your Song. Slovenia's entry to the Eurovision tonight was not one of the bookmakers' favorites going into the competition, and the entrant admitted she wrote the song in just a few minutes. Lee Cirk said of her EDM tune Hola, Ni, which translates as No Thanks, "I wrote it in 10 minutes, before the submission deadline." Among the celebrities tweeting along to Eurovision was Boy George, who wrote, "I'm watching at Eurovision and embroidering." How camp is that? The Eurovision contestant for Estonia, Elina Nacheva, took to the stage in a dress which host Graham Norton has said was worth €65,000. Cheryl Baker, a winner of the competition with Bucks Fizz, offered commentary on the initial acts with a glowing assessment of Lithuania, Austria, and Estonia, while writing of Spain, ZZZZZZZ. The competition is estimated to have been watched by around 200 million people around the world. The event was hosted in Portugal this year after its 2017 entry. Salvador Sobral won with a restrained solo ballad last year in Ukraine in 2017.